Napoleon's return stirred up the French population, which was deeply dissatisfied with the dictatorial rule of the Directory. This name derived from the executive power exercised by five members known as directors. Even though he suffered some defeats in Egypt, Napoleon returned as a hero and was acclaimed by the people. The Directory became concerned and even accused Napoleon of desertion for leaving Egypt without having received official orders to do so. The charges were unsuccessful due to the lack of support from politicians who were against the Directory. Napoleon formed an alliance with Lucien, his younger brother, and president of the Council of 500, along with director Emmanuel Joseph Sieyès and other allies. They overthrew the Directory in a coup d'état on November 9, 1799, known as the coup of Brumaire 18. This event is also considered by some historians to be the official end of the French Revolution. Napoleon and his allies formed a new political regime called the Consulate, where Napoleon was elected to the position of First Consul, obtaining dictator-like powers and control over the most important affairs of France. Concerned to legitimize his power, Napoleon drafted the Constitution of the Year 8 and secured his own election as First Consul, choosing the Tuileries Palace as his residence. The Constitution was approved in a fraudulent plebiscite, with 99% of the votes in favor. During Napoleon's time in Egypt, France had lost almost all the territories it had conquered in the War of the First Coalition. To reverse the situation, Napoleon set out again for northern Italy, where he faced Austrian armies. Inspired by the tactics of the famous general Hannibal Barca, Napoleon surprised his enemies by crossing the Swiss Alps and reaching Italy via an unexpected route. After a difficult crossing, the French army entered the plains of northern Italy without encountering much resistance from the enemy forces. On June 14, 1800, the Battle of Marengo took place. Napoleon commanded 24,000 troops against 30,000 Austrians. The Austrian forces had an apparent advantage, but the French lines never broke in their tactical retreat. Napoleon rode constantly among the troops, urging them to resist and fight. Near the end of the day, the French overcame General Michael von Melas's surprise attack, driving the Austrians out of Italy. In just 1 month, Napoleon forced the Austrians to sign a new peace treaty, finally consolidating his political position in Paris as First Consul of France. Napoleon's new position created a new wave of dangerous enemies, among them opponents belonging to the monarchist parties and Jacobin extremists who came to fear the man whose ambition seemed limitless. There are reports that Napoleon suffered several assassination attempts. The most famous occurred in Paris on the night of December 24, 1800. Napoleon was traveling toward the opera to see Joseph Haydn's oratorio when a carriage exploded on the street just as his carriage passed. Napoleon survived the bombing unharmed, although the explosion killed a dozen spectators. About 40 people were injured, and several buildings were damaged or destroyed. Police investigations found those responsible for making the bomb, who were executed on April 20, 1801. After a decade of constant warfare, France and Britain signed the Treaty of Amiens in March 1802, ending the Revolutionary Wars. With Europe at peace and the economy recovering, Napoleon's popularity reached its highest levels, and he was recognized at home and abroad. In January 1804, the French police discovered a new assassination plot against Napoleon that had the involvement of the Bourbon family, the former rulers of France. In retaliation, Napoleon ordered the kidnapping of Louis-Antoine de Bourbon, the Duke of Enghien. The Duke was quickly executed after a secret military trial, which angered royal courts throughout Europe. It was one of the political factors that contributed to the outbreak of the Napoleonic Wars. Napoleon used this new assassination plot to justify the creation of an imperial regime based on the old Roman model. This would create a hereditary system for the Bonaparte family, who would have the right to rule France and the other conquered territories. Also, in 1804, Napoleon was elected Emperor of the French by a vote count of over 99%, with almost 3.6 million voters. This devotion of the French population to Napoleon is considered a rare event in human history. Napoleon's coronation, made official by Pope Pius VII, took place on December the 2nd, 1804, at Notre Dame Cathedral in Paris. Napoleon entered the ceremony wearing the golden laurel wreath and kept it on his head throughout the proceedings, honoring the customs of the ancient Roman Empire. A second crown, a replica of Charlemagne's, was brought for the ceremony. This was symbolically raised above Napoleon's head, but placed on the head of his wife, Josephine, making her Empress of all France. The following year, Napoleon was also crowned King of Italy, with the Iron Cross of Lombardy in Milan Cathedral on May 26, 1805. Among his generals, he chose 18 imperial marshals to ensure the loyalty of the French army. But the peaceful period had come to an end in Europe. Britain broke the peace treaty and allied itself with the Holy Roman Empire, Russia, Sweden, and Austria, starting the War of the Third Coalition. Napoleon knew that the French fleet could not defeat the British Royal Navy in a direct battle, so he planned to lure it away from the English Channel. The plan fell apart after the British victory at the Battle of Cape Finisterre in July 1805, where the French Navy was again torn apart by British ships. Realizing that he would have problems if the Austrians received reinforcements from the Russian armies, Napoleon moved his army to southern Germany. The Battle of Ulm took place between October 16th and 19th, 1805. The Battle of Ulm is generally considered a strategic masterpiece. Napoleon organized his troops to flank and surround enemy positions, forcing the surrender of Austrian General Karl Mach and capturing a total of 60,000 troops. The French exemplary performance in land battles was not shared by the French naval squadron, which suffered a crushing defeat at the Battle of Trafalgar on October 21st against the British Royal Navy. That was the last time the Royal Navy was seriously challenged by a French fleet during the Napoleonic Wars. After the Ulm campaign, French forces captured Vienna in November. The fall of Vienna provided the French with a huge reward, capturing 100,000 muskets, 500 cannons, and the unharmed bridges over the Danube River. On December the 2nd, the Battle of Austerlitz was fought in Moravia. The battle is often considered a tactical example to be followed, given the near-perfect execution of a calibrated but still dangerous plan. With the same stature as the Battle of Cannae, fought by Hannibal Barca against Rome some 2,000 years earlier. The Allied disaster at Austerlitz significantly shook the faith of Emperor Francis II of the Holy Roman Empire. France and Britain again agreed to sign an armistice between the two powers. Napoleon even said, "The Battle of Austerlitz is the best of all those in which I have ever fought." After Austerlitz, Napoleon divided the conquered German states and established the Confederation of the Rhine, ending the Holy Roman Empire. The territorial reorganization eventually alarmed the Kingdom of Prussia, which felt threatened by the steady advance of the French. King Frederick William III of Prussia eventually gave in to the pleas of his wife and ministers, forming new alliances with Russia, Saxony, Sweden, and Great Britain. The War of the Fourth Coalition against Napoleon began. Napoleon invaded Prussia with 180,000 troops, marching rapidly on the right bank of the Saal River at the battles of Jena and Auerstedt on October 14th. The French quickly defeated the Prussians, who suffered heavy casualties. Several enemy commanders were killed or disabled. This victory was especially profitable for Napoleon's army. In 1 month, the French managed to capture over 2,000 cannons and hundreds of ammunition wagons. Then, Napoleon and his troops captured the city of Berlin, the capital of the Kingdom of Prussia. There was a huge plunder in the city, and Prussia became a client state of France, forced to pay large indemnities. While in the city, Napoleon visited the tomb of Frederick the Great, former King of Prussia. He repeatedly told his marshals, "Hats off, gentlemen. If he were alive, we would not be here today." In 1806, Napoleon sought to form new alliances in the Middle East. The Ottoman Emperor Selim III recognized Napoleon as an ally, as did King Ali Shah Qajar of the Persian Empire. But Napoleon was unable to form effective alliances due to the intervention of Britain and Russia, who declared war on the Ottoman Empire. Napoleon was now a living legend. Few would dare challenge his position as emperor or general on the battlefield. But his future would still have many twists and turns and great moments.